Hello everyone, today I want to share with you a wild Snip-Snap Mech Hunter deck. Mech Hunter is a super aggressive, budget-friendly deck. New Mech Legendary fits perfectly into this aggro deck, where Galvanizer and especially Mechwarper can discount it. In that slot, I used to play Cybertech Chip, but Snip has tons of value, so it's a great improvement to the deck overall. After experimenting with bomb toss cards, I can say they are better than upgradable framebots that I used to play instead, mainly because of the additional aggression they provide. I like to use magnetic minions on Mechwarper and Jeeves to boost their health, so they are much harder to kill. Best cards for Mulligan are Mecharoo, Galvanizer, Mechwarper and Metaltooth Leaper. And with all of that said, let's play the game! Alright, worthy opponent found. Let's play. Improved aggro Mech Hunter. Our opponent will be Mage. Okay then. Let's see our starting hand. We are searching for the Mechwarper and Galvanizer. That's what this deck all about. We have the Snip Snap in the starting hand. Don't have to play the Fateful Lumi immediately. It will be free with the Mechwarper, so he will play Secret Keeper. Alright, so let's kill the Secret Keeper with the bomb then. Alright. So Bomb Toss is one of the new cards in this deck compared to the last version. Archaeologist played. Okay. Ursa is there. So let me see here. I would really like to play the Mechwarper now, but that will waste one mana kinda. But it will let me play the War Gear next turn. So for that reason, let's just do this. Okay. So buff the Mechwarper, of course. As long as he is on the field, we get big discount. So now if he wants to play a secret, he will not be able to kill the Mechwarper. Oh, Kirin Tor Mage with the secret. So he had a great start there, I have to say that. Will he attack something? Yeah, he kills the bomb. He kills the bomb. Alright, let's see what we can do. We can do two Snip Snaps as well. That's really strong. That's really good. So maybe play that. We will have a full field of minions basically after that. How much health will it have? 7 health. Okay. So let's do it. There we go. So let's kill Secret Keeper first. Okay, and kill this one now. That's great. That's really good. We have Ursa who will be able to fill our hand a little bit with new cards. Sorceress Apprentice needs to die. Oh no, this is bad. That's bad. We are not able to attack immediately now. Let's see, let's use 5 mana. So let's play Annoyo and Ursa. Okay then. He had explosive runes and the divine shield will soak that. That's great. We are not losing the minion. There from his secret, he will trade. Okay, the Metal Tooth Leaper is going to be really good here. So let's see what we can do. Can play Galvanizer, maybe. We will get 4 microbots. Alright, this secret does not affect minions, so this one dies anyway, right? So let's go kill this one. Alright, let's go with Metaltooth Leaper. This will be enough damage on the board now, and let's go. We will probably win this game. Yeah, there we go. Easy ranking up with this deck, that's for sure. So let's play another game. Alright, the second game is ready. Let's see. Our opponent will be Hunter. Okay. Mechwarper is in the starting hand, that's great. Faithful Lumi will be kept as well, and let's reroll these two. Alright. So we will get Bomb Toss instead, and the Ursa. Alright, probably even going to coin the Mechwarper. We will see what type of deck we will be playing. Can be anything really. Alright, so the game is starting. Will he play anything now? Not really. Okay then. Let's go for the coin. And the Lumi will boost the Warper there. We will be able to play one of our mechs if the Warper survives. Alright, so Galvanizer played. We are playing against... Indeed, we are playing against the mirror there. So let's boost our Faithful Lumi. Let's see, what is the smartest way to go about this? Lumi can boost a Lumi. Alright, that's good. He can then kill the Galvanizer. And let's play the Ursa. Okay, we have the upper hand considering we are playing against Mirror. So we have quite an upper hand here then. Let's see what will he do now. His mechs are also discounted because of the Galvanizer, so here comes Frame Bot and the Venom. Alright, this is great for us. That's great. We will be able to play one of our cards, and that one card will be Spider Bomb for sure. And we will just go and kill this one. Let's magnetize the Spider Bomb so it actually is able to attack immediately, and it dies there. Alright, great turn of events for us, and we have the Metaltooth Leaper, basically 9 damage bonus there. That's great, and the Bomb Toss can go face. We are even close to killing our opponent here. Well, let's see his next move. What will it be? If he doesn't play some kind of a taunt, maybe a Noyo, it'll be really hard for him to come back from all of this. Oh, the War Gear as well. But let's say War Gear. It's only 5, but this is 9 damage bonus, right? So let's play that one. Just go for the face. Just go for the face, it doesn't matter anymore. Alright, play even a Bomb Toss. So we have additional bomb that we can magnetize War Gear. That's great. We were totally dominant this mirror match, so yeah, this game should be over very soon. Alright, he's gonna do some magnetic action there as well. Oh, that's a great combo. He managed to fill the field quite a lot there, but it will not be enough. Okay. Let's end this game. There we go. Alright, new game is ready. Our opponent this time will be Priest. Okay, then let's see our starting hand. This is great. I like to keep the Jeeves in my hand. Really do. Just thinking about Spider Bomb should not be necessary. Should not be, I guess. It's nice if we are playing against a big Priest, we can use it and kill a big thing with it. So for that reason only, let's keep it. Against other opponents, I would really not do it. Alright. Galvanizer next turn. Let's see if he's gonna play something. I really doubt it. Most priests actually play big stuff, right? Okay. There we can use our cards as fast as we possibly can, because we do have Jeeves. So let's go with the Mecharoo and Spider Bomb. Let's magnetize Galvanizer. So he has 4 attack. It will be harder to kill it, right? It will escape the shadow words of all kinds. Alright, next we can play one of our cards only, and probably the best one will be War Gear, right? Let's do magnetize action there and attack the face. Okay, so 4 mana. Let's see what he will do now. He can play something now. Like the Vargot or something. Okay. Shadow Word Death Blade. Venom is a nice card. Let's see. We have the Jeeves and we have Venomizer. We can maybe play both of them. Can I help you, sir? And let's do the Venom. So it's additional attack basically. Mechwarper arrived. That's great. Let's see what his next move is. He has the coin though, so he might decide to use it this turn. Yep, here it comes. Maybe Shadow Essence. Yes, exactly. Katrina played. And since we get the War Gear, this game is over. This game is done as well. Hell yeah. There we go. So, as you can see, this deck is great for climbing. And I hope you guys liked the video. I hope it was fun and informative. Give this improved Mech Hunter deck with a Snip-Snap a try. If you like fast-paced decks, this might be the deck for you. Stay tuned for more Hearthstone content. Please like and subscribe. Thanks for watching and see you soon.